Good afternoon. Welcome to the commencement ceremony. I would like to have a moment of silence in honor of all of those who paid the ultimate sacrifice for the defense of our country. Thank you. Additionally, I would like to honor those who are either currently serving in the military. Our veteran can give you a round of applause. On behalf of our country, I thank you. To welcome Mr. A.J. Detling to the stage to lead us in prayer and to offer some opening remarks.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for this day and for making this to us. We pray that you are with them as they graduate and go out into the world on their own. We pray that you watch over them, guide them, and may they always turn to you for direction. We ask this in your name. Amen. Please be seated. Good afternoon. On behalf of my classmates, I would like to welcome the administration, staff, family members, and friends to Barnesville High School's 2021 commencement ceremony. Everyone here today has made an impact on these graduates, whether it has been in the classroom, in an extracurricular activity, or at home, present for the last 4 years. As I stand here today, I now know why students are not jumping at the chance to be the class president. Our art teacher, Mr. Johnson, was the head football coach, and the current head football coach and English teacher, Mr. Allen, was a student at Muskingum University. My brother, RJ, my sister, Grace, myself, and most of you were just starting out as kindergarten. I think we can all agree that this year has been a lot different than we would have ever pictured our senior year to be. We lost part of our junior year and came back to it. We heard the phrase, due to COVID, more times than we can count. We have a year's worth of pictures filled with masks and social distancing. The obstacles this year seem to be endless at times. I believe that despite all these roadblocks, we can all rejoice in the fact that we made it. In true Barnesville fashion, we pulled together. This small town is known for stepping up when people are in need, the same sporting events, or hosting our own homecoming. We adapted every time. This class has learned firsthand how to overcome obstacles. We have learned to use our resources. I am proud to be a graduate of the class of 2021. No class will ever have the experiences or have learned the lessons we have. Remember this school year, remember this pandemic, remember the people who helped you along the way. Remember that you are stronger than you know, you have the ability to dig deep when life gets rough. Remember your classmates, remember that high school on the hill. Remember the green, you need a reminder of what you are capable of. Let this year serve as a constant reminder to always help someone in need when you have the opportunity. Take the lessons you learned this year and during our time at Barnesville High School and apply them. To BHS, RBHS, Congratulations, Class 2021.
At this time, I would like to introduce the superintendent of Barnesville Exempted Village School District, Mrs. Angela Hannes.
The 143rd graduation at Barnesville High School. At this time, I would like to recognize the guests on stage. Mr. Rob Miller, president of the Barnesville Exempted Village School District Board of Education. Mrs. Katie Dentling, Vice President. Mr. Aaron Brueggemann, Board Member. Mr. Dennis Huntsman, Board Member. Mr. Kenny Mack Triplett, Board Member. Mr. Ron Clark, High School Principal. And Mrs. Natasha Schilling, High School Guidance Counselor. There is a saying that history repeats itself. According to Barnesville historian Bruce Yarnell, the Barnesville High School class of 1971 was the first class to graduate at Shamrock Stadium. The administration at that time planned an outdoor ceremony and also made contingency plans for the ceremony to be held by ticket only. The following week's is perfect setting. Next week's headline in the Barnesville Enterprise may also note something similar. Even though the weather today is not ideal, while we can breathe a sigh of relief and enjoy today's celebration, just a few months ago, we were not sure if it is considered or evaluated. If I asked any of these seniors to evaluate their senior year, I would get 100 different opinions. At this point, all guidelines from the Ohio Department of Education, the Ohio Department of Health, the Belmont County Health Department, the Governor, the Ohio High School Athletic Association. Senior year, with every classroom, Zoom meetings, social distancing, masks, quarantining, temperature checks, and sanitation, they came defeated. They did not feel sorry for themselves. They did everything that was asked of them without complaint. I will focus on their bright futures and all the new memories that they will make, because these students have walked through a storm like none we have ever seen, and their rainbow is waiting for them on the other side. Their handling of a school year in the midst of a global pandemic is proof that they can and will handle anything life throws at them. So when you hear the question, senior for the answer. Congratulations to the Barnesville High School class of 2021.
Ms. Morgan Winters will now make her way to the podium.
Good afternoon. I wanted to start off by congratulating all of my classmates and friends on achieving this major accomplishment in our lives. Right here. We're living this moment that we could barely imagine when we were all in elementary school. Although we never realized it until after it's happened, we lived through so many other milestones together as a class too. Graduating kindergarten, all of those core events that makes high school, high school. Everything, whether mundane routine or major milestone, we did it together at the same time in the same place. Out of all of the people and places and times we could have spent our adolescence, we ended up here together. I would also like to give thanks to everyone else who contributed to getting us all this far. The support and encouragement have played such an important role in all of our achievements, and I think of elementary, middle, and high school, we wouldn't be here celebrating this moment today. I can't wait to see where the rest of our lives takes us all. Each of us are now finally choosing our own individual paths and beginning a new chapter of our lives in which we may not be with each other physically, but will always be with each other each step of the way in memories and in spirit, cheering each other on with every goal that we achieve on the way to becoming adults. The lives that we've lived in high school and in this town together may be over, but the start of the rest of our lives is just beginning today. This is an unforgettable milestone, but we have so many more to come and so much happiness and positivity in the world.
This year's valedictorian, Ms. Caitlin Rowe, will now make her way to the podium.
Good afternoon. My name is Caitlin Rowe, and I am 21. I want to thank everyone who has made today possible and who has fought for us to have some sense of normalcy throughout our senior year. I would also like to thank you all for coming to join us in celebration as we close an abundantly important chapter of our lives. Furthermore, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to my family, friends, classmates, and the staff at Barnesville High School. Your support and efforts do not go unnoticed, and I know I would not be where I am today if it weren't for each and every one of you. Now, I want to share with you a statement I heard from a customer at my work a few weeks ago. At a hardware store, yes, a blonde working at a hardware store, Kyle's captivating remark has remained in the back of my mind. The customer said, "It's one thing when you don't want to do something, but it's another thing when someone tells you that you can't." This is reflective of COVID-19 and the plethora of restrictions we have undergone. No doubt graduates will never get back. We will never again have the chance to participate in sporting events, sit in the greenhouse, go to homecoming and prom, or even just attend high school classes. 4 years later, I am realizing that these seemingly minuscule events, as difficult as it may be to fight off the tyranny of regret or resist the pondering what ifs, it is crucial to remember that we have the capability to appreciate our mistakes and adjust our mindsets for upcoming endeavors. So as I stand here today conveying what you can't do anymore, I hope you have no regrets. I hope you have made your choices wisely and do not wish for a chance to go back. I hope you have realized the significance each and every choice plays in our lives and the effects each one has on not only our futures, but also who we are as people. There are going to be moments that will impact your life just as much, if not more, than high school has. When you reach this next major milestone in your life, whether that be a college graduation or a promotion in the workplace, so much more that you can do now. You can move away, you can follow your dreams, and you can continue to grow and develop into the person you desire to be. So if you're having any regrets about what you might have said no to and missed out on throughout high school, dreamed of. In the wise words of Amanda Gorman, there is always light if only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it. And so, my fellow classmates, congratulations and best wishes to your future. Go and live your dream.
I would like to now introduce Mrs. Schilling, the high school guidance counselor, to present the students graduating with honors and to introduce the students who have achieved the Ohio Means Jobs Readiness Seal for their diplomas.
Thank you. With the following, Grace Stetling, Jacob Edwards, Victoria Fraley, Kinsey Caplet, Abby Moore, Riley Stevens and Winters. Congratulations. You may be seated. Alana Trey.
Mr. Rob Miller, at this time, based on the completion of all requirements set forth by the Barnesville Exempted Village School District and the Ohio Department of Education, I present to you for graduation the class.
Our superintendent mentioned about 50 years ago the class of 1971 receiving their diploma out here. I was part of that class. Little did I realize that 50 years later to this day, in just about the same time, I would be presenting diplomas to this class and to my grandson. I presented probably five of the board members with their diplomas, and many of them especially. As AJ talked about the changes over the last 4 and 5 and 6 years, over the last 50 years, there have been a lot of changes, and there'll be a lot more changes because that's who we are, people of change. There are three things that I want to leave this class with that have helped friends, and in that order. And they will help them and all of us through difficult times and times that are ahead of us. And I encourage them never to be ashamed of any of those three and to embrace them in difficult times and in joyous times. I'd like to recognize one person at this time as he's entering into the military, Nova Pavel, who already stood for us, but stand again, Nova, if you will. Takes a lot of courage, and I appreciate that young man. But on behalf of the other board members, these guys having satisfactorily completed all the requirements set forth by the Barnesville Exempted School District, the State of Ohio, and as president of the Barnesville Exempted Village Board of Education, I gladly accept them for graduation at this time.
The moment you came here for. Will the first row please rise? Samantha Elena Jo Carpenter. Janetta Irene Campbell.
Yeah, Janetta!
Aaliyah Mae Burley. Tessa Nicole Butler. Bailey Madison Bunfield. Jaden May Bassa. Rafferty Cunningham Cassiopo III. Christian Colvin Carpenter. Clay Michael Carpenter. Craig Dale Carpenter. Will the first row please be seated, and will the second row please rise? Serenity Alice Coleman. Alexis Diana Connor. Lily Angelique Star Cottle. Yeah. Grace Rebecca Detling. Destiny Ann Dowdle. Charles Edward Christman. Kyle Matthew Denham. Aiden Jeremy Detling. Rylan Jeremy Detling. Logan Eugene Eddy. Will the second row please be seated and the third row please rise. Caroline Jo Fedowski. Victoria Lee Fraley. Dalen Marie Harvey. Madison Faith Hubner. Shayla Ray Hunter. Jacob Ryan Edwards. Anthony Jacob Francis. Brad Michael Hall. Gage Oliver Hannes. Will the third row please be seated, and will the fourth row please rise? Courtney Madison Leister. Kinsey Lee Kaplan. McKenna Ray Johnson. Phaedra Ray Charlene Jackson. Alan Hetherington. Alan Hetherington. George Roger Hoover III. Will the fourth row please be seated and the fifth row please rise? Randall. Alyssa Suzanne Pabalchik. Gail Murphy. Mackenzie Elizabeth Moore. Abby Jean Moore. Dalen Mercer. Connor Thomas Johnson. Talmadge Allen Johnson. Robert Mitchell Littleton. Will the fifth row please be seated, and the sixth row please rise. Olivia Lynn Marie Starr. And Alicia Marie Simmons. Mackenzie Taylor Schultz. Alina Renee Sarver. Caitlin Brianne Rowe. Raven Ray Richmond. Ethan Christopher Pack. Nova Skyler Pavel. Luke Matthew Schultz. Hayden Thomas Skinner. Jacob Michael Starr. Will the sixth row please be seated, and will the seventh row please rise? Anna Lynn Wallmeyer. Alana Riley Trigg. Olivia Lee Tolliver. Haley Elizabeth Tipton. Isabella Ann Street. Riley Catherine Stevens. Kai Parker Tui. Richard Timothy Weaver III. Levi Hunter West. Brady Allen Wilds. Clayton Edward Alonzo Wilson. Will the seventh row please be seated, and will the last row please rise? Morgan Elizabeth Winters. Haven Jean Williams. Haley Ray Wilcox. Emma Margaret Wharton. Would all of the graduates please rise? Please move your tassels from left to right. Please rise for the benediction in alma mater, please. At this time, I would like to invite Ms. Kinsey Caplet to lead us in prayer, and then the senior class will lead us in the alma mater.
Opportunity we have all had to learn and grow. Help us to stay true to ourselves and our dreams. We ask that you be with us as we go.
Seniors, please lead us in the alma mater. One, two, three. Music, please, Mr. Hissom.